Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I wanted to show you guys everything that I've been loving in the month of April. I have so many favorites this month, so many things that I was like, damn, I really want to tell you guys about this because I just feel so strongly about my opinion about them that I wanted to share it with you guys. I also have a couple misses that I will share with you guys at the end, but let's jump into the stuff that did work for me. The first thing I wanted to mention is the Tartiste Pro Palette from Tarte. I have been using this eye palette nonstop this month. I ironically don't have it on my eyes today. I actually just got done filming a first impressions video as well as a haul video, so I'm kind of like doing marathon filming today, guys. This is what this palette looks like. If you have not picked it up yet, I highly suggest that you do so. It is just kind of like the perfect palette. There's everything you could possibly want in it. There's warm tones, there's cool tones, there's pops of color, there's neutrals, there's shimmers, there's mattes, there's transition colors, there's everything. Every single thing you would need in a palette. Plus, it has this oversized giant mirror, so I would think that this would be like literally the most perfect palette to travel with. I have basically only used this palette this month. I've created so many different looks with it. I just love it. It's my go-to, I know, like, fail-safe palette that I could create any look with that I know that I'll love. So to keep on with the eyes, I have been obsessed with this mascara this month. This is the Maybelline Lash Sensational. I know this is by no means a new product on the market, but it's newer to my collection. It's newer to my testing it out. I love the wand on it. I love how it has like that scooped curve so you can really get in there, get in nice and deep, like into the lashes, get a lot of volume at the base. It also does give me great length as well. So it kind of is just an overall great mascara for me. It is a little bit more of a wet formula. The only complaint I have is that sometimes there's a lot of product on the wand and I gotta like scrape some of it off. I mean, if that's really my only complaint, that's like trying to find something to complain about with the product. So I have been like a skincare junkie in the month of April. I love my skin right now. I just love it. I think it looks so great. Not today. I'm actually wearing a product that is part of my misses of this month. But in general, I have never liked the way my makeup has looked on me any better than all these products that I've been using in my routine. This is an oldie but a goodie, the Tarte Maracuja Oil. This has just been a staple of mine for years. And I go back and forth where I use it like religiously and then I stop using it for a while. But every time I reuse it again, I remember why I love it so much. It just makes my skin look so much better. I'll use this at night. I'll just put a couple drops all over my face, really blend it in well. That's definitely a key to it. You just can't like put it on there and kind of blend it in. I really take a lot of time, even a couple minutes, to get it really blended into my skin. I think that that's definitely been making the difference lately, and it's just really bringing out the best properties of the formula. I've also been obsessed with this little guy right here. This is the Mint Pear C Your Youth Vitamin C Serum. This actually came as a sample in my latest Ipsy bag, and I'm obsessed with it. I think that this is probably the number one thing that has made my skin look 20,000 times better than it's ever looked before. This is one of the only really new things I've added into my routine. And like I said, I've never loved the way my makeup has looked better. I am planning on purchasing a full size of this. It does run pretty hefty in price. I think that this guy in a full size price is over $70, which is insane to me for a skincare item. I'm obsessed now. I don't know if I could have not have this in my life, so I will probably more than likely take the plunge and purchase the full size of this. If you guys would like to see a dedicated skincare routine video or skincare products, like my favorites, my misses, anything like that, please let me know down in the comment section. So I've been trying out primers like crazy in the month of April. One that I basically cannot live without my routine now is the Milk Makeup Blur Stick. This is just the little sample size of it. I did purchase the full size in the Sephora VIB sale. That haul video should be up very soon. It's either gonna go up before or after this video. I have basically used this guy down to the nub. I love it. I use this all on my T-zone, on my chin, my upper lip, my nose, my forehead, and then I use my fingers to blend it in. It has just been a great mattifying and blurring primer. I also take it out onto my cheek. So like right here, because that's definitely where I notice the most pores if I have them. And it does a beautiful job. Like I said, I've never loved the way my makeup, especially like in this area, has worn ever until I started using this product. I've also been equally obsessed with this Catrice primer. This is the Even Skin Tone Optically Prime and Fine Beautifying Primer. It's a soft, focused, effect, long-lasting, naturally illuminating primer. It is a complete mouthful, but it really does everything that it says. I apply this mainly on my cheeks, and it does give a very beautiful, pearlized, very blurring effect to the cheeks, and it really does make my makeup last much longer than it would if I didn't have that on. I will swatch it for you guys so you can see. It does come out in this like a little bit of a pink tint right there, but it doesn't look pink on the skin. It actually feels a lot more like a moisturizer. But as you can see, it does give the skin this natural, really pretty illumination. Smell-wise, it's not like the most fragrant smell. I do notice that scent at first when I first apply it, but I don't like, it's not like I smell it throughout the day. I have not noticed any additional breakouts while using this primer. Honestly, I have this as well as I have the Marc Jacobs Coconut Primer. And honestly, I kind of tend to lean a little more towards this, and it's so much more affordable. It does also give me some decent moisture on my cheeks. I don't feel like I look very dry and patchy on my cheeks during the day. Overall, I have just been obsessed with this primer. I will definitely repurchase it once it runs out. So I have been using this foundation nonstop over the last couple weeks. This is kind of just my daytime foundation, and honestly, I think I'm actually almost out of it, because you can definitely tell, like, from first initial use of this foundation to now, it's a little bit of a struggle to get the product out of the cushion, but I love the way that this foundation looks on my skin right now. I think it's a great daytime foundation. I've been loving my skin so much lately, I don't feel, sorry, there's neighbor kids outside and they like scare the crap out of me out of the corner of my eye. I've been loving the way that this looks on my skin. It gives a very beautiful, like, natural illumination. It's also been a great product if you are having like really, really good skincare days and you don't need, you know, an excessive amount of foundation on your skin. This gives you just enough because it is pigmented, but it's like more of like a medium coverage. I'm gonna insert a picture like somewhere up here I took on Instagram. I've just been loving the look of like a no makeup makeup look lately. I just really put a big focus on skincare and, you know, making my skin look good over the last couple weeks and kind of been playing it down a little on the eyes, and I've been absolutely loving the way it's been looking. But to complement that, I have been obsessed with this concealer as of late. This is the one I use underneath my eyes, and I do have it on today. This is the Lancome Camouflage Ultra Wear Concealer. I'm not even going to try to pronounce the rest of it because it's in French and it's just not happening. But it is an Ultra Wear high coverage concealer, and I do like very high coverage concealers underneath my eyes. I do have darkness, I do have fine lines, so I do like to combat that as much as I possibly can. I will say this product is something I can't use alone, at least. I don't feel like I've gotten comfortable enough or found a product yet that I could just use this alone with. I actually use this in combination with my argan oil. This one's just from Physicians Formula. I just put a tiny little, like, not even a pea size, like a half a pea size amount on the back of my hand. One drop of this, like literally just one drop of this. I mix it together and make it more like a serum. Pat it underneath my eyes, go in with this guy that I'm about to talk about. In general, I've been very much enjoying this concealer, and it was expensive, but you definitely get, you get a 0.40 fluid ounce size bottle, and I barely use any of this. I don't see myself running out of this anytime soon. So I did want to mention this guy, and I apologize, he is disgusting right now, but this is the Eco Tools Beauty Sponge, and I think that this may have replaced my love of the Beauty Blender. It is so soft and squishy. It still has some squish to it. But what I love so much about it is that you get this rounded side like the Beauty Blender. You get the pointed side similar to the Beauty Blender, but then you also get these flat edges, and these are just so great for getting right in there underneath my eyes. If you were to bake, this would be a great product too to bake with. It does come with another one. It comes with, pull it over here, it comes with this smaller guy too, which this is definitely a lot denser. This is not the same as this. This, you can tell how squishy this is in comparison. This is just, and then like this one, I like struggle. As you can see on here, I use it actually for cream contouring, and I do really like it for that. But this is definitely like my go-to, probably my holy grail beauty sponge. Of not of this year, maybe of all time, I don't know. This comes very, very darn close to the Beauty Blender, and you could replace this twice a year, still cheaper than the Beauty Blender. So if you guys are wondering about the lip combo I have right now, I have been wearing it nonstop for the last couple weeks. It is these two guys right here. The first one is this Tarte Lip Lingerie. This is a Crayon style lip product, and it is in the shade Exposed. It is one of the prettiest everyday nudes, neutral nudes that I own. I love this so much. It is definitely mattifying. It's not really glossy at all. I love the color of this. I love the application. It has this almost like this blurring effect right by the like the outer corners of your lips. I love that you can go as soft or as pigmented with this as you want. If you just want like a really light wash, you can just kind of go over black and it looks beautiful. If you want something a little bit more pigmented, you can really build it up. I think it's a great application. As you can tell, this is really well loved. I have like the product all over the bullet part of this, but, and you get a decent amount of product in there. I mean, I'm still twisting and it looks really gross. I'm sorry, I'm so perverted. I've been topping it off with this lip gloss every single time. This is in Magnetic Mauve and it is from Lancome. This is just one of the prettiest lip glosses I've ever owned in my entire life. So I actually bought this on recommendation from another YouTuber, Kelly Strack on YouTube. Thank you, Jesus, for recommending this lip product to me, because I don't know if I could never not have this in my life. So this is what it looks like. It's right next to the exposed lip color. It is just the prettiest, like, your lips look like water, glass, whatever. It's so pretty, but what I love the most about it is that I can literally like layer this and layer this and layer this and layer this, and it doesn't get gross and goopy and like get all over my teeth and settle into like the corners of my mouth. It just stays beautiful. I actually picked up another shade of this. I had it on actually in a couple previous videos. I tried it in my first impressions video. I will say, I think I like this one a little bit better. I think the formula is just slightly different. I find that one a little, like a tiny bit more sticky. I've been just tossing this in my purse lately. This is the only lip gloss I've been using in conjunction with the exposed lip lingerie crayon from Tarte. These two have been my ride or dies pretty much all of April. So I've been loving this primer water, especially like right before foundation application or to kind of freshen up my foundation throughout the day. The Smashbox primer, the Photo Finish primer water, has been such a staple for me in the month of April. And I would say not really until recently did I really start falling in love with this. I think it's great, especially if I find that I'm having a little bit more of a dry day. I will spray this on, like I'll dot my foundation on, spray this on, then go on with that beauty sponge I showed you guys, and it just looks so good and it kind of just gives life back into my skin. I would probably definitely be repurchasing it as well. I'm kind of bummed that I didn't grab one during the sale, or I know that this was on sale like during the 21 Days of Beauty. They've had this like the last couple times on sale, and I'm kind of pissed I didn't grab one then, because I'm like, I don't need it. I'm not gonna fall in love with this again, so. Little did I know. I have been obsessed with this Milani setting spray. This is the Milani Make It Last setting spray, the Prime and Correct and Set 16-hour wear. As you can see, this is grungy as hell. I throw this into my makeup bag every single day. I'm actually gonna set with it right now because I am so hot that this is just gonna feel good. Oh yeah. Oh, it smells amazing. I love the spray of it. I love the mist of it. The only complaint I have is that it's a little bottle. I'm already definitely more than halfway through it. I think I'm gonna be running out of it very soon, but I will definitely be repurchasing it. It is one of my favorite drugstore setting sprays that I have used so far. And really, this formula compares to like Urban Decay and other high-end brands. So if you guys are looking for a spray on a budget, I think this was under $10. If you're looking for a setting spray on a budget, definitely go check out the Milani setting spray and the Make It Last 16-hour wear. And then there's just been one fragrance this month that I've been in love with. This is the Body Shop Satsuma Body Mist. This is one that smells a little bit more orangey, more like tangerines. This is just kind of like my go-to everyday body spray. I really like fruitier, fresher scents in the summertime, and this one just smells so good. And orange is one of my favorite scents. Like, I love citrus and orange and lemon and all that goodness. What I like about the body spray is that, one, it lasts all day long. Like, I will smell this from when I first put it on to like when I'm going home from work. I will smell it on me. It's a really good, long-lasting spray. I have a feeling I will be repurchasing this one because I really, really do like it. Okay, guys, so it is unfortunately the time to go over my miss products of, or misses products or missed products of April. I was about to say February of April. This one I'm actually very, very, very sad about. It's like part of me wants to keep trying it because I know I loved it so much the first time. And I even really, really like loved it when I first started using it again. When I bought like a full size one and started using it again, like the first week or two, I was like obsessed with it. I'm like, I will never not purchase this high end mascara ever. But the last couple weeks have pretty much dramatically changed my mind. So this is the Josie Maran Argan Black Oil Mascara. What I love about it is like, this is one of the blackest black mascara formulas I've ever used in my entire life. It gives you so much volume at the base. It gives you great length. I can only layer this about twice though. Anything past two even sometimes two, looks really spidery and gross because this is a thick formula. I really also do like the wand on it. It has this like multi-hourglass shape to it. What I have been not liking about it, it's like flaking like crazy on me. It wasn't doing it initially, so I just don't know if this one just is dried out now. But I did try to remedy it with this. This is the Laura Geller Fortifying Lash Eyelash Primer. And literally the first time I used this, like these two together, it worked. I was like, great, I found something that will make this, you know, still wearable that I can actually get through the whole tube. The second time I used it, it was awful. Like, just black under my eyes. It was just like transferring so bad under my eyes. Not just flakes, like full on like black transfer under my eyes. It was horrible. I was like, what the hell is going on? Because again, this has never happened to me before. I don't have like mascara transfer like some people do because I don't really have oily eyelids. It had to have been one of these two, and I'm pretty sure it was this because I never had like full on color transfer until I started using this. So this was definitely a miss for me. And then the elusive Dior Forever foundation was 1000% a miss for me this month. I've used this now twice. The first time I used it, I was underwhelmed. Not like I totally hated it, but I was like, eh. I like had a more loving relationship with my Giorgio Armani the first time I used it, or my Urban Decay the first time I used it, or any other foundation the first time I used it than this one. I put this on today. I kid you not, I can see every single pore. I can see every single texture, like I can see texture on my skin. But I know I have texture on my skin, but I just exfoliated this morning, so I'm like, should it really be that bad? I have not seen this amount of pores and texture and grossness on my skin. I haven't seen my foundation break up like it's doing right now on my skin until I started using this foundation. I first actually initially got it because Jaclyn Hill was raving about it, which again, I pretty much buy anything that she raves about. It's just every single place I could just see my pores and I could see all my texture and I could see flaws and I could see lines and I could see wrinkles. I could just see everything. I'm seeing wrinkles in my forehead that I know don't exist. So that's clearly a problem. So I absolutely did not like that foundation this month. Let me know if you guys liked it and if you have a way that you wear it that you actually like it. So those are all of my hits and misses for April. Thank you guys so much for joining me. If you guys want to see a specific tutorial using any of those products or different, like, you know, specific product demonstrations, let me know down in the comments section. Make sure you guys stay tuned for my Sephora, my Ulta, and my empties video coming up soon. I just filmed the Ulta one, so I'm not sure if that's gonna go up before or after this video. I will be filming my Sephora one soon as well. Make sure you guys give this video a big thumbs up as well as hit that bell over there so you get notified every time that I upload a video. Also, make sure you guys follow me on all my social media channels. I'll link them all down below for you guys. Thank you guys so much again for watching my video today. I will catch you guys in my next one. I love you so much and bye. Oh, my boobs are getting sweaty.